Hello, welcome to another unboxing and review. And today I'll be reviewing another wonderful product that you're going to be using for the installation of your solar panel and your battery inverters. So today I'm going to be unboxing and reviewing the Felicity Solar MPPT Charge Controller. So before I move on, I would like you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Lift Up Infotech, like the videos, and also make sure you share to friends and family. And I want to assure you that I'm going to be dropping 3 more videos on how to install your solar, and make sure you watch out for it. Let's go there. So quickly, I'm going to tour around the box of the Felicity Solar MPPT Charge Controller. So here you can see it. We have the product here. You can see the image right here, and we have some few features here that I'm going to come back to explain to you. And we also have the MPPT Solar Charge Controller. You can see the Felicity Solar, and here we have nothing. Then here we have some information that you just need to know about the charge controller. So the MPPT Solar Charge Controller, you have the model, the rating current, the battery voltage, the PV voltage, the net weight, and the gross weight. So I think apart from that, there's nothing else to look around the carton anymore. So quickly, let's go and talk about the features of this charge controller. So before I actually talk about the features of the Felicity Solar MPPT Charge Controller, let me just explain some few things about this charge controller to you. So first thing, it is a MPPT Solar Charge Controller. So what is the meaning of MPPT? It means maximum power point track. So why is it called MPPT Solar Charge Controller? It is called MPPT Solar Charge Controller because it makes sure it gets the maximum out of the solar panel or array and gives the best back to the battery. And also, this is a Felicity Solar brand, which is one of the best solar charge controller brand you can ever get in the world, and also in Nigeria here. So now let's talk about some of the features of this charge controller. Also, before I explain some of the features, what the charge controller actually does is just make sure it takes the best from the solar panel, the best energy, current and voltage, and give it to the battery, and make sure that the battery is not overcharged or undercharged. So it has perfect protecting function, which you can see here. So what does it mean to have a perfect protecting function? Unlike the former design of this device, where when the PV has high current and voltage, the device, which is this charge controller, gets damaged. In this new device, this new charge controller, when the PV or the solar panel has a high current and voltage entering into this charge controller, it does not get damaged. It automatically disconnects the PV from it. And also, you can see save its radiation and the IP20 protection grade. So the IP20 protection grade here actually means this is a touch proof and a dust proof, but it is not a liquid proof or waterproof. And this save its radiation means at the back of this charge controller, in which I'm going to be showing you, you're going to see a heat sink that helps to regulate the heat coming out from the charge controller. So we also have the tracking efficiency. The tracking efficiency can reach up to 99.8%, which means it can make sure it gets up to 99% best out of the solar panel and give it to the battery, so that it can be able to charge with a good current and full voltage. So the next one is the excellent design inside and outside, touchable buttons. Wow, when I unbox this for you, you're gonna see the design. It's very wonderful and better than the other device, the former device. And you know, it makes use of a touchable buttons right now, and it's very fine that you can even install it in your parlor where you don't actually have to hide it, maybe in your store. It's very beautiful. And the last one is the 4-level charging pattern, which can extend the lifespan of battery. So this particular MPPT solar charge controller has a 4-level pattern, which actually make sure the battery has a long lifespan, you know. So it makes use of the buck, the absorption, float, and also the equalized four level charging patterns, which actually help your battery to last long and make sure it stands for a long durable of time than just getting spoiled quickly. So let me unbox this and I'm gonna be showing some of the features of it on the body.
Hey, before you continue watching this video, I want to quickly tell you about something. Have you heard about OPay before? OPay is a mobile banking app which allows you to transfer money to other banks and even OPay users, pay your bills like your electricity or cable bills, buy airtime or data to all network, and do some other transactions. When you create an account and join OPay, you get a welcome bonus of 1,200. But remember, for you to get the bonus, you must credit at least 2,000 naira from another bank. You get up to 6% cashback anytime you make a bill payment. There is free transaction and zero issues. You'll be able to get an instant and free debit card. All you need to do is for you to check the description section or the comment section for the link. Click the link and you'll be able to create your own OPay account. Now back to the video.
So I'm gonna be unboxing this charge controller right away, and I want you to know that it comes with some other accessories in which I'm gonna be showing you. Before I bring out any of it right now, I want you to know that I did a quick and short video on unboxing this particular product. Make sure you check it out on my YouTube channel as a YouTube short. So it comes with this manual that shows how to install the charge controller on the wall, and this particular manual, in which you can see my hand, is actually the same size with the charge controller. So the particular paper here can actually help you to install the charge controller on the wall. It also comes with the warranty card here, and also comes with this user guide, in which you can see right here. This is the user guide, so you can also open and check through this user guide so that you can be able to understand the charge controller, how to use it, how to install it, and how it works. So here is the main product which I'm gonna bring out right away. So this is the charge controller, the Felicity Solar MPPT charge controller. I'm just gonna unbox it, and I've already unboxed it. So this is the product, and I'm just gonna be showing you some of the things I talked about on the carton about the features of this product. So first thing is, you can see the new design is very beautiful. It is white in color, and also you can see the touchable screen. This place is a touchable screen, a touchable button. I mean, you can touch this, and it also has some indicators here, right here, and an LCD display which you can see here. At the back, you see the heat sink that helps to radiate the heat. The heat coming from the charge controller is being collected by the heat sink so as to reduce the heat from the main charge controller. So also, this particular charge controller is a 60 amps rated voltage. So this particular charge controller is a MPPT solar charge controller. We also have other types of charge controller like the PWM regulator. We also have the series regulator and the shunt regulator, but this is the best of all, and that is why I'm unboxing this right here. And also, this is has a rated current of 60 amps. So it depends on the kind of solar you are and battery inverters are trying to build. So if you are trying to build something between 3 to 4 panels and some few batteries, you can make use of the PWM. But if you are trying to build something larger than that, you can make use of this MPPT charge controller. And this one in particular is a 60 amps rated current. We also have the ones of like 120 amps rated current. And also, another thing to know, it makes use of a screw box, so which is easier for you to fix your wire, like your inputs, your PV inputs and your battery inputs. And it also has a communication port, the RJ45 communication port, which also makes it advanced because you can actually check how your device, the charge controller, is performing through your device, your mobile device, and also like your laptop. So yeah, it also has some little holes that air can pass through to cool down the charge controller. And also for the other side here, you got the same thing. So you also have some little information about the charge controller here, which you can see, and also some ones here which you can see, and some of it are also on the body of the carton of this charge controller. So let's take a look at the difference between the new design, which is what you can see here, and the former design of the charge controller. So let's talk about the differences between the new design, which you can see right here, and the whole design. So I'm gonna be placing the picture of the old design in this video, which you should be able to see right now. The old design actually makes use of a clickable button, but this makes use of a touchable button, which is this. That is one of the differences you can see in between the old and the new design. This one makes use of a screw box hole for you to connect the cables to it, which I showed you earlier here. Can you see it here? It makes use of a screw box hole. But on the other hand, the former one makes use of a cable lock hole, so you can be able to connect it. Another difference between the former design of the solar charge controller and this new one is that the other one, which you are going to be seeing on the screen right now, actually have this metal cover here, where you actually have to open before you can be able to access the cable lock to input your cable. But for this one, you just have these screws here, where you just actually have to unscrew, then be able to input the wire below here, and then you just have to screw it and tighten it back. So that's for it. And that thing is, for the former one, it actually does not have this disconnect automatically. It does not actually automatically disconnect if it has a high PV voltage, which actually led to the damage of the one we were using. I was actually using a former Felicity solar charge controller, and it got damaged because the PV voltage coming in at a particular time was too high. So for this, which you can see here, it actually disconnects whenever the PV voltage is too high, which, you know, will not lead to the damage of this particular charge controller, and then which will not lead to you expending more cost or money to repair it whenever the PV voltage is high. It just disconnects automatically, and that is very, very wonderful about this. And thanks to Felicity Solar for improving in that area. So let's talk about some similarities between this new design of Felicity charge controller and the old design. So both of them actually have a LCD display here. So for the other one, it actually have, but for the other one, the display is in green, and for this one, it doesn't actually show green. It makes use of like a whitish color to display. Also, both of them actually have these indicators, but for this one, you actually have three indicators. For the other ones, you have two indicators. And also, both of them actually make use of this heat sink, where you can see right now, for safe heat radiation. Both of them actually make use of this heat sink. And that is the major similarities between these two designs. And both of them perform greatly, and I know you're gonna love it. So that's all for the Felicity MPPT solar charge controller. And if you want to get anything related to solar done or for your installation and battery inverter, make sure you check the number displayed on the screen currently, or go to the description section where you're gonna see it. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our videos, share to friends and family, and just check out the Lift Up InfoTech YouTube channel for more interesting tech videos. Thank you very much. Bye.